Hello, and welcome to our vegetable trial garden in South St. Paul. I'm Lisa Glover, a Dakota County Master Gardener. One of the vegetables that we'll be trialing this year is delicata squash. We'll be trialing 6 different varieties of delicata squash and monitoring their growth throughout the season. We'll be looking for things like germination rate, any issues with diseases or pests, overall plant vigor, and at the end of the season, we'll be looking at both the quality and quantity of the harvest, as well as the taste. But today I'd like to tell you about delicata squash, and then talk to you about some things you should consider when planting your squash in your home garden. Today you can find delicata squash in supermarkets, farmers markets, and hopefully in your home gardens. Delicata squash is a member of the cucurbit family. That comprises of not only summer and winter squash, but also cucumbers, melons, pumpkins, and gourds. Its botanical classification is Cucurbita pipo. Delicata squash is considered a winter squash because it matures and is harvested later in the season. Its days to harvest, or from seed to harvest, is 80 to 100 days, depending on the variety. And although delicata squash's shelf life is not as long as some winter squashes, it can be stored for up to 3 months after harvest. But the unique characteristic of delicata squash is that its outer skin, when prepared, is tender, or delicate, as the name delicata implies. So it is edible and does not need to be peeled before preparing. Delicata squash is also known for its very rich and sweet, even creamy flavor. It tastes much like a sweet potato. In fact, some people nicknamed this the sweet potato squash. With its edible skin and sweet, rich flavor, delicata squash is ideal for stuffing or slicing and roasting, but it can be prepared in a multiple of ways and is very versatile. I'm really excited to try the delicata squash varieties that we're trialing here this year. Here we are next to the delicata squash that we've planted in our garden. As you can see, they already have germinated and are growing. I'd like to tell you a few things to consider when you are planting your winter squash. The first is the site. All winter squash require full sun and rich, well-drained soil. Because they are heavy feeders, they benefit from having a soil that is rich in organic matter. You can improve your soil by adding compost or well-rotted manure in the spring when the soil is workable, or even in the previous fall. But I'd also highly recommend that you have your soil tested in the spring and then follow the recommendations on the soil test report. This will take the guesswork out of any amendments or fertilizers that you might need to add to grow your winter squash well. The next thing for you to consider is the space. Most winter squash are large vining plants and require a lot of space to grow. If you have a smaller garden space and don't necessarily have the room for large winter squash to vine out, you might want to consider looking into varieties that have shorter vines. They might be called bush or semi-bush varieties, and some seed sources will call them or will give you an actual measurement or call them short to medium vining plants. All of our delicata squash are either semi-bush or short to medium vining winter squash. Another thing for you to consider is where your water source is. Squash require at least an inch of water per week, either through rainfall or from some source of irrigation. So you won't want to be trudging hoses and buckets of water, especially when it's dry. So you'll want to have a water source close by. Then sowing your winter squash seeds. This can be directly done in your garden soil when it has reached a temperature of at least 65 degrees at a 2-inch depth. Actually, waiting until 70 degrees or so would be ideal. If you plant your squash seeds in soil cooler than 65 degrees, you may run the risk of the seed rotting before it actually germinates. We waited until our soil was well above 70 degrees to plant our squash seeds. We did that on May 24th. We planted the seeds 1 inch deep, and we followed the instructions on the back of the seed packet as far as the depth to plant, as well as the spacing and between rows and between plants. So you can refer to that when you're planting your winter squash. Now, regarding spacing, you might also want to grow your winter squash vertically. And by that I mean on a trellis system. You can see we have these wooden trellises here. If you use a good sturdy materials like wood or perhaps a cattle panel or some other sturdy fencing, you can grow your squash up to save space. And as long as it's good sturdy material, it'll be able to bear the weight of the vines and the squash. One more thing to consider is using mulch. We do like to mulch our squash plants because it has many benefits. Those being keeping the moisture in the soil, keeping the weeds down, and it also helps prevent water from splashing back up onto the leaves, which also helps prevent diseases. In my next video, I'll be talking to you about common insects and or diseases that you might encounter when you plant winter squash.